Why teach mathematics? Despite the advent of fast, accurate computing technology that we can carry around in our pocket, we still need people to be able to think mathematically. Mathematical ideas and arguments are often used in public and private discourse. Our modern media is awash with claims and counterclaims based in mathematics. People need to be able to respond in an intelligent, sophisticated way. Fundamentally, we need our students to become confident and creative users of mathematics, able to fluently pose, model, and solve real-world problems. They need to learn to reason their way logically through complex situations, recognizing and following connections between different ideas in order to reach a justified conclusion. Mathematics is a powerful tool to manage life's myriad demands. This is reflected in the emphasis in the Australian curriculum on numeracy, growing our students' capacity, confidence, and disposition to use and apply their mathematical understanding and skills in everyday life. When you can succeed with it, mathematics becomes fun, exciting, beautiful, and powerful, an enjoyable discipline to study for its own sake. And some of our students will go on to further study in mathematics. We need them to. We need future engineers, statisticians, researchers, scientists, accountants, economists. The list goes on. Think about all the different ways you use mathematics in daily life. You use it at home, shopping, in leisure and sport. You use it at work, whether that's work for somebody else or in business for yourself. In fact, you probably rely on maths even more if you're working for yourself. Sometimes my high school students try to get out of doing their work by arguing that they don't need to know how to do it themselves, they'll just pay someone else to do it for them. My response is, how will you know that they're not ripping you off? This view of mathematics as an active, creative discipline is quite a contrast from the more traditional view of maths as a dry subject learnt by memorization and rote repetitive practice. Only 20 years ago, maths was taught as a fixed body of knowledge, a set of rules and procedures that had to be learnt by heart and applied to a large set of routine questions that bore little relationship to real life. This approach came out of a sociological view of education as being about equipping tomorrow's workers to contribute usefully to society. Today, maths is seen as a much more creative and individual activity. Now, some of these ideas are a reflection of the current emphasis on constructivism in education, which I don't personally hold as being the best way to teach, especially in mathematics. Topics are organized and structured around children's psychological development, rather than necessarily following the historical order in which the ideas were discovered or developed. Notwithstanding the new Australian curriculum's introduction of some quite abstract concepts in algebra well before most children are ready for it. But that's another story. Maths is best learned, according to current theory, in an active, problem-based environment. The purpose has changed from equipping workers for the factories of the industrial world to equipping adults to survive and thrive in our fast-paced, technology and media-driven world. The ideas of mathematics are useful for a wide range of diverse purposes, not just a specific toolset for a specific set of jobs. One more thing about maths and education. Mathematics is in fact not just a body of knowledge or a set of procedures. It's a language, a symbolic language for explaining, understanding, and communicating ideas and truths. As a language that has developed over millennia, it's become a way for people to exchange ideas in an unambiguous way, independent of any particular native spoken language or culture. It is concise, meaning it's possible to express complex ideas in relatively little space, and it's rich and versatile enough to apply to almost any and every field of human endeavor. But that leaves us with an interesting question. If maths is a language, what implications does that have for the way we go about teaching mathematics? What can we learn from language education that can help us with mathematics education?